Good evening. Welcome to our spring concert. My first order of business is to remind you to turn off all cell phones. The students have been working very hard to perform for you, and that can be a big distraction to them. I am Joyce Dubach, if you are not familiar with me. I am the director of the Fine Orchestra, which you do not see out here at the moment. We're doing a little something different on this concert. We decided to do some chamber music. Chamber music is sometimes called music of friends. It's done with a small group, one person, usually just one person on a part. And it's a little bit different than playing in an orchestra. In an orchestra, you're one of a section. You have many people playing. If you make a mistake, you're usually covered up by one of the other people playing the same part. But when you play in chamber music, one person on a part, you are responsible for that part being there and being accurate and in tune and making all the adjustments that you need to. So this has been a little bit of an adventure for these students to do this. I pushed them a little bit out of their comfort zone, but they went right with me. I think you'll be very impressed with what you hear. So we're going to start, without further ado, with our first ensemble.
Thank you.
Just a word or two to introduce our next piece, Beethoven Incorporated. I've always been very intrigued by music that combines more than one tune at a time. And in this piece, you will find the familiar Ode to Joy theme from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, but you'll also hear a few other familiar tunes, such as Can Can, Hallelujah Chorus, William Tell Overture. So it's perfectly acceptable to give a smile or even a laugh if you choose. Beethoven Incorporated. For our final selection, we're going to recognize a couple of members of the orchestra. This is usually the time we recognize outstanding students, and so we are going to do that now. The first one is the National School Orchestra Award. It's given to the outstanding senior musician. And I wish I could build suspense a little bit more, but since we only have one senior, I don't think it's going to be too much of a surprise. This is an excellent student. She's been serving as concertmaster this year. Challenged herself to go to solo and ensemble with a solo. She's also a very talented pianist and went to state, I believe, on piano as well. So I'm very pleased to present the National School Orchestra Award to Amy Beer. The next one will be a little bit more suspenseful because this is the Baton Award. It's awarded to a student, not necessarily a senior, who has contributed significantly to the orchestra over the year, especially this year. All of these students have contributed throughout their entire time. So it's usually very difficult to pick somebody, and it was again this year. But we did have one student that kind of went above and beyond the call of duty. Not only did she improve as a musician, but she also kind of took on an extra role. And when we ordered T-shirts for the orchestra programs, both at the high school, Wawasee Middle School, and Milford Middle School, she took charge of that. Made my life very easy. She just took the orders, filled them, brought me the shirts, said, take them to them. And it just made my life so much easier. So the Baton Award this year goes to Casey Gungle. Our final selection is a Beatles tune, Here Comes the Sun.
Thank you. For our first piece, we'll be taking you to a place where Mr. Brower here may or may not have hair, but going back to the future.
Hopefully I'll be thinner.
We're gonna go back in time to the dinosaurs with Jurassic Park.
Thank you.
We are playing Raiders March from the movie Raiders of the Lost Ark, which was made in 1981, a series of Indiana Jones. Enjoy.
We will now be playing Pixar.
Thank you. We would like to recognize the seniors tonight from both orchestra and concert band.
The students filled out a paper of different things that they wanted to mention this evening about where they're heading, and thanks to special people in their life, and they're going to collect a carnation from Dr. Dubach and take them to their family members. Okay. The first up is Amy Beer from orchestra. Yeah, not sure where Amy's at. Amy would like to say thank you to her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Randy. Deb and Randy Beer. She's played the violin, and her most memorable orchestra moment, she says there wasn't one in particular, just having a good time with the orchestra family, no matter what. Her message for her parents is, thank you so much for supporting me and all that I have taken on, and I love you guys. Post-high school plans is to pursue a nanny job in the fall of 2018. Next up is Sadie Grummy. Parents, Lori Prescott and Ted Grummy. Band awards, she plays the clarinet, the bassoon, and the flute. Most memorable band moment is bickering with Heaven and Landon. Mm-hmm. A message for parents is thank you guys so much for your support. Post high school plans is to attend college for business management. Next up is Zach Hunter. Parents are Mr. and Mrs. Molly and Jeff Hunter. And he's played the saxophone, alto, pretty much the whole time. Am I right, Zach? Did you play alto the whole time? Okay. Most memorable band moments was walking onto the field for the first time. Message for his parents are thank you so much for all of your love, support, and especially the food. His post-high school plans are to attend Purdue Fort Wayne in computer science. Shay Hen. Parents are Tracy and Mark Hen. Instruments he's played is percussion, especially quince and timpani. Most memorable band moment this year is being a part of the first drum line to make it to semi-state. Message to his parents is, thank you so much for supporting me in all that I do. He plans to attend IPFW to major in history. Okay. Mandy Mall, daughter of Sandra Mall. Instruments she's played, trombone and baritone. I noticed you didn't mention flute in there somewhere. Yeah, okay, all right. Or drum major. Okay, all right. Most memorable moment in band was Garrett's vocal cues. Okay, not sure what that means, apparently they do. Message for parents, thank you for supporting me, I love you. Post high school plans is to attend IU Bloomington for foreign language education. Megan Wells, parents, Dina and Bruce Albitz. Hope I said that right. Did I say Albitz? I'm so sorry, Albitz. She's played clarinet and bass clarinet band. Most memorable moment was Mr. Brower trying to hit me with an eraser but missed and hit someone else. Message for her parents is that I love you so much. Post high school, she plans to attend Manchester University to major in criminal justice. And our final senior of the evening is Mr. Cody Walker. Mm-hmm. Kathy Henwood and Garrick Walker are his parents. He has played alto, tenor, and barry saxophone, all with success, I would say. Most memorable man moment was going to semi-state for marching band. He wants his parents to know that he loves you both, and thank you all for the support. Post-high school plans is to attend the 1150 Academy for Computer Programming. Thank you all.
I Well, hope you're ready for a happy ever after. And this is our last song. It's Disney.
Thank you.
That concludes our concert, so thank you for coming and watching.